When it's raining, your vision gets obstructed because of those raindrops sitting on your glasses. Do you want to get rid of this problem once and for all? So guys, I'll give you a solution that your glasses will never get those raindrops ever again. So let's get started. But before that, please subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon so that you can receive notifications of the latest upcoming videos. Let's move forward. So, question number one, why does liquid, or in our case, water, wants to sit on the surface of your glasses? That's because it has a low contact angle. For example, did you just see what happened when I dropped the liquid, water in this case, on the surface? It's completely wetting the surface of the glasses. So that means that it's making a very, very low contact angle, and that's basically causing the wetting of the surface. So what we want to do is that we want to make the surface of the glass hydrophobic, that it does not allow water to sit on its surface. How can we do that? That's what we are here for today. So I'm going to use auto ceramic coating. It's a nano coating. It's also called a nano coating. So we are going to coat the surface of the glass, or the glasses, with the nano hydrophobic coating. And as a proof, what I'm going to do is that I'm not going to coat all of it. I'm going to coat this part, all of it, and this one, half, so that you can clearly see that water will not sit on this part of the glasses, and it will sit on half of the glass and not on half of it. That will be an absolute scientific proof that we have a success. Let's go forward. Before we even proceed to make the hydrophobic coating, step number one, take a tissue paper, clean the surface of the glasses with the tissue paper so that there is no grease. The point is, you shouldn't have any grease on the surface of the glasses. And the way you do that is, number one, you take a microfiber towel, clean the surface as nicely as possible. Be careful, don't break the glasses. Don't press too hard. Step number two, take some rubbing alcohol and with a tissue paper on it, and gently clean the surface with rubbing alcohol. That will make sure that there is no remnant grease on the surface of your glasses. Once this is done, let it dry. You see it's drying out. Nice. Step number three. As we planned, I will apply tape on half of this portion. Don't touch the glasses again, because the grease from your fingertips or from your hands will go and transfer onto the glasses, and you don't want to do that again. You already cleaned it pretty nicely. So now step number four. Is that four? Yeah. So I'm going to coat the hydrophobic coating on this, but it's really important that you put on some gloves, because this is silica, SiO2, and you don't want that to get onto your hands. So I'm going to use a towel that actually comes with the hydrophobic coating thing. So let's open this thing up. Put only 2 drops, not more, guys. 2 drops are enough. By the way, I'll put a link in the description of this video where you can buy this. I got this from AliExpress. I got this for less than 10 euros. So you can see the change of the color of the surface. So basically what you want to do is you just want to make a nice thin layer. This layer is extremely thin. You won't be able to even see it with the bare eyes. And again on this side, the amount that is there in two drops is more than sufficient to basically cover the entire surface. Just make sure that the entire surface is covered. So you'll see a change in the coloration. Don't worry about that. Don't worry that your glasses will get harmed. So what I'm gonna do is that, just note the time. I will be back in 10 minutes. Guys, it's important, 10 minutes and not more. Because if you wait for more than 10 minutes, it will be detrimental for your surface that you're coating. So I'll be back. So guys, I'm back after 10 minutes. So what next I will do is that I'll take a clean tissue paper or towel, whatever you want to call it, and just wipe out all the extra or remaining hydrophobic coating or silica coating or nano coating. Just wipe it out. You don't want any of that remaining, and the way you can see it is by the reflection. You won't be able to see any coloration. You see that there is a little bit of it left there. Just wipe it out. Yeah, and the reason why I said that you shouldn't be waiting for more than 10 minutes is because the silica begins to sit in the nanopores of these glasses. But if you wait for more than 10 minutes, more of silica will start to, you know, solidify over there. And that means that you may get more than what you need, and an obstruction in the image could happen. So right now, it's good enough. Once all the extra coating is gone, you can just test it with water. So let's test it with water, guys. So the moment of truth, guys. I'll just peel this off. So you see that you don't see any difference. A very, very thin layer. So what I'll do is I'll just pour water, and you'll see that how it stays on this portion but will drip down on this portion. See that? So the raindrops are not going to stay on your, they just want to drip down. Let's look at this portion. They just want to stay here. Beautiful demonstration of science. But let's not just stop here. I'll just put this glasses under running tap water. Let's go on to it, guys. So I'm gonna put this in running tap water. You remember, this part is not coated, these parts are coated. Water doesn't want to stay here, it's all running down. Thank you. Let's stop the water and get back to our work table. So guys, we are back on our work table. What we have done is that I'm gonna clean this with my microfiber towel. So what we have done is we have successfully made our glasses water repellent. It will not get water from water droplets from the rain or anything else sticking onto its surface. So this can be done with any sort of glasses, your vision glasses. I can guarantee you that it will not obstruct, because this is it won't obstruct your vision. It's just a very, very thin layer, nanometric layer. It has been proven in labs. And these are the same hydrophobic coatings used for coating or for glass coating the cars. So guys, let's call it a day. It's a success. So like always, if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe to my channel for the very new ideas, upcoming videos, and hit the bell icon as well. And as always, thumbs up. Oops.